Coming up on MHS1.
We look at our senior superlatives.
We check out our teachers' top 10 essentials.
And more.
And it's all coming up on MHS1.
After 6 years, a cherished member of the Downtown McKinney businesses Carpe Diem Comics has closed their doors. The owners Shadow and Liz share cherished memories and thoughts on the future.
There was a free comic book day a couple of years ago. We were just stupid busy, falling out the doors busy. We had a couple of guests, we just had lots of things going on, and it felt really awesome. Like, the energy was really good. People had been standing in line for an hour for free comics, and they were still happy, they were still cheerful, they were still making friends with the people in line around them. And I was just standing up in that corner looking down on it, and it was like, this is our place, we built this.
I would just like to say that, first of all, it made us happy every time someone said, oh, my students, or, you know, the guys that I coach or whatever, talked about being in the store over the weekend and hanging out and said that they feel like it's a really safe, comfortable place. That, you know, that was what we wanted. And I would really, really, like I said before, like to see y'all keep doing that, keep finding spaces, keep pulling people in, keep making people feel safe. Because it's a scary world, it really is. And if you can find people who accept you as you are and who don't pressure you to be things you're not, and who just say, hey, you're cool, let's hang out, that's the best feeling.
My next job is gonna be 40 hours a week, $25 an hour, no leadership role. That's it. That's my criteria. So if anybody watching this has something, I am open to work. Invite them to the comic club. Invite them to play D&D. Invite them to come over and play video games. Invite them to go hang at the mall. Invite them to dinner. Invite them to do whatever. Make a friend. We all need friends. And this was a place for making friends.
And that's our legacy, and that's what we want everybody to keep doing and expanding outward.
If you're interested in keeping up with the two, Shadow and Liz can be found under their Instagram handle Carpe Diem Comics. This has been Ty Quarles and Charlie Taylor reporting for MHS1.
We brought 6 people together to play a game of fraud. 5 of them are seniors and 1 is secretly a freshman. Their goal? The seniors have to try and rule out the freshmen. They will have 3 minutes to discuss them, and if there's a tie after voting, the people that tied will have 20 seconds to prove their case.
I have a question. Who's been y'all's favorite principal so far?
Eleanor Bobby.
Yes,
who
yes,
got
yes,
it?
Yes.
Wait,
what'd you say?
Our Bobby.
No, somebody said what? Miss Bobby?
I just said Mr. O'Bobby.
Yeah,
I didn't even know his name.
I love Mr. O'Bobby. Yeah. I love him.
He's so funny. I took a selfie with him right before he left.
Yes, I did. I had to make sure I got there.
Yeah, if you don't, you're not a senior.
Literally. Like, wow. He was so chill.
I just remember his fan page.
So what extracurriculars are you on?
I'm in ROTC.
I don't have any. I just have office aid and I start late.
Yeah, I'm at Abbott in theater.
I'm in theater and head on.
I do engineering after school, but I'm mostly in student aid.
Wait, how long have you been in theater for?
Since sophomore year.
Were you a year ago?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
hold on, because I was in your town. You don't sound
like it. I have a question. Do y'all have a parking pass, and have y'all been threatened with the little orange stickers?
I have a senior spot.
Oh yeah, I have a senior spot too.
Like, I ain't got time for that.
I don't drive, I catch the bus.
Yeah, that's okay.
But yeah, I got the parking pass.
Do you have a senior parking spot?
I ain't got time for that. I was like, when it was due, it was so, I'm so last That's minute, fair. So I ain't got time for that.
What's your favorite teacher for the past few years?
Mr. Mira.
My favorite teacher? Like dang, that's a hard, let me see. It will be Mr. Sanders, my math teacher. He's been there.
Senora Adams, for sure. Love her.
I had her for childhood.
Mm-hmm. I had her when she taught Spanish.
Oh my God, freshman year?
Yes.
Oh my God. What class did you ever, what period?
Oh my gosh, I think it may have been sixth.
I was in seventh.
Really?
Yes, I used to love Senora.
What do y'all have, I mean, what are y'all doing after? Graduation. What are y'all plans after high school?
College.
What college?
I'm going to Texas A&M Commerce.
Real?
Duh. Come on now.
I'm going to Texas State.
Oh, that's good. I love Texas State. We visited there for amateur.
Really?
It was cool.
It's so pretty, but there's a lot of stairs.
Oh yeah, it's a lot of stairs. I'm tired.
So I think my biggest pet peeve would be this tardy system we got here at I, because I'd be going to class, I mean, I may be a minute late, then I get a tardy, and I end up being
teachers.
3 to 4 minutes late now. Like, you know, I'm trying to go to class, just let me go, you know?
My pet peeve is probably school lunch, because, like, sometimes I'd be hungry, and, like, I'd be going to lunch, and I'd be looking at what they got, and, like, it's not really it, so I still get it, though, because, like, I'm hungry.
My pet peeve is when people ask stupid questions because it lacks common sense. Like a question, you know, where they ask for help on something and they don't listen. Like somebody asks where something is and it's right next to them. Like they didn't even try to look for it or anything.
I'm trying to use the bathroom and there's piss on the floor. And what? Like this one time when I was trying to piss, I slipped on the piss and like I fell on the floor. So that's my number one pet peeve.
That's all we have for you today, Lions. Make sure to follow us on Instagram and TikTok at MHS Mainstream.
And make sure to listen to the Mainstream podcast on Spotify or on our website, mainstreamnews.com.
And remember, if it's news...
And it's at